The long-awaited Samsung Galaxy S8 has arrived at Appalachian Wireless. Get yours for the introductory price of just $149.99 with a 2-year service agreement. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless, an East Kentucky network company.
Before we get to all of the sports action going on around the region earlier today, Jenkins High School announced the newest addition to the Cavalier football program as Matthew Chandler was named head football coach. Chandler is a native of Letcher County. And now on to the action. District tournaments finally got underway today as we head to Johnson Central for the 57th District Softball Tournament. The Magoffin County Hornets played as the home team against Johnson Central as the two teams faced off in the championship game of the 57th District. Offense was hot for the Eagles as Elena Castle hits a single to center and drives in Macy Daniel and gets the Eagles on the board early. Keeping things rolling in the same inning, McKaylin Pierce lines a single to left field and scores Allie Wendland. In the process later in the game, Allie Wendland, she's now at the plate and she gets a 2 RBI single up the middle to stretch out the lead by bringing home Elena Castle and Allie May. The Golden Eagles take home the 57th District Championship by a score of 13-1. The Lady Eagles will be a 1 seed in the upcoming 15th Region Tournament. Other softball scores from around the region, Betsy Lane had the upper hand in the 58th District Championship as they defeated South Floyd 19-4. And in the 59th District, Eastridge picked up a 2-1 win over Shelby Valley to advance to the championship round, where they will play Pikeville tomorrow morning at 11. And in the 60th District, for the third consecutive time, the Lawrence County Lady Bulldogs pulled out the championship win in 8 innings against Belfry. Final score, 3-2. On the baseball diamond tonight, district action wrapped up as well as we head across the region. Starting with the 57th District, the Johnson Central Golden Eagles and the Paintsville Tigers took the field to battle it out for the 57th District Championship. Johnson Central 27-7, Paintsville 16-5 on the season. Johnson Central moving early, Cody Rice steals third, bad throw, and he will wheel his way around to home plate for the first run of the game. Runners on in the box, Trevor May, he sends one to left field, and the Golden Eagles get another run with an RBI from May. And then Riley Priest standing in now, runners still in scoring position, hard hit grounder up the middle, and the Eagles continue to move around the bases, going up 3-0 on the Tigers early. Runner on third now for Johnson Central. Riley Sarton steps up to the plate, and he'll hit a ground ball to the third baseman, but Jordan Blanton will slide across home plate just in time to score the fourth run of the inning. The Eagles win the 57th District Championship for the fourth straight time. Final score, Johnson Central 14, Paintsville 5. In the 58th District Championship, Prestonsburg blanked Allen Central 13-0 to be named champions. And for the championship of the 59th District, the Shelby Valley Wildcats took on the Pikeville Panthers. The Panther offense showed up hot tonight from Eastridge High School, starting with Tyler Elkins. He's at the plate, and he gets a single past the second baseman, allowing Andrew McNamee to come around from second and score easily for the Panthers. Later in the game, Jackson Hensley, he's now at the plate with a little small ball. He lays down the bunt to third. The third baseman comes up and fires to first, but no one is home, and that allows Tanner Thompson to come around and score on the throwing error. Pikeville wins the 59th District Championship for the 9th consecutive time. Final score, Pikeville 8, Shelby Valley 0. And from the 60th District, finally finishing a game that took place on Tuesday, Lawrence County defeats Pike Central 13-5 for the 60th District Championship. And of course, lots of games going on around the region, and they continue next week with the region tournament beginning on Monday.
Very good. And we'll be right back.